Tonight, is that a pajama party? No way. It's Michael Jackson and his entourage showing up over an hour late to court. It's a pajama party, everybody. Grab your pillow. Michael Jackson showed up to court today in his pajamas. Jane, what a day. Bring me up to date.
It was one of the most astounding days in a courtroom ever. It's 8:30 a.m. We're all there waiting. The jury's outside, though, and suddenly the judge comes in. I see that the defendant's not present. His attorney, Tom Mesereau, jumps up. He's got a serious back problem, judge. He's in a hospital. The judge doesn't want to hear it, doesn't want to talk to the doctor, and says, I am issuing a warrant for Michael Jackson's arrest. I'm forfeiting bail, but I'm going to hold it for an hour, and then the clock starts ticking, and it's a mad scramble to get Michael Jackson from this hospital about 37 miles away to this courthouse. The motorcade finally arrives. The doors fly open before it even stops, and out comes Michael Jackson, moving very slowly for somebody who's at least 4 minutes late and could go to jail. He finally makes it in, and the judge, I guess, decides to be a nice guy and not send him to jail and let the 4 minutes or 5 minutes go. And they resumed with this key day of testimony. The accuser on the stand telling his story of molestation allegedly by Michael Jackson. And I don't think it's any coincidence that Michael Jackson chose this particular day to do what he did. He says that on two occasions, Michael Jackson masturbated him. He says that Michael Jackson started talking to him about how masturbation was normal, that males need to do it. The boy says that Michael Jackson told him a story about another boy that he'd observed once that didn't masturbate, who ended up having sex with a dog, and said if males get to a level, if they don't masturbate, they might have to rape a girl. I mean, this is incredibly graphic. And then says that Michael Jackson on two occasions reached over and masturbated him while they were in his bedroom at Neverland. But of course, who's dominating the subject today of this trial? Michael Jackson himself, with what he pulled this morning. And you know, he is really, in a sense, in control. You say the judge is in control, but I think because he is really dominating what the headlines are going to be, in a way, Michael Jackson is the puppet master. He's proven that today.
Everybody talking about how Jackson won the day and controlled the courtroom. Reality check. The jury saw the guy with his hair a big mess, uncombed, unkempt, in his PJs, his jammies. I don't see how any defense attorney can say this was a win for Jackson in court today.